Welcome to video number 18 on working with Traincontroller. The past few videos have been about engines, and we are not yet done with them. This video is about how we can get our own engine images to work in Traincontroller. As we see, at several places the engine images are in use, like here in the train list, or here with the throttles, or here in the layout in the blocks. So it would be nice if those images are the real actual images of the engines that we have running around instead of just any image. We can select the image that we like to use per engine by going into edit mode and then double click the engine, and in the general tab of the properties window we can click the image and then select one from a list. Don't know why I got popped out, and that list unfortunately is not that long, so chances are that you cannot find the engine that you are looking for in this short list. Well, luckily it's also possible to browse for an image on your computer. And this opens up a browse window where you can find an image, but there's a little issue here. The good news is you can use an image of your own, but the bad news is it is not as easy as just using a standard JPEG or bitmap, because Traincontroller uses a special file format, like we see over here, the YRA format. And there is an extra program, an additional program, to create those files for us. But then again, the good news is that program is downloadable for free. So let's have a look how we can acquire that program. Let's go to the internet browser and go to the FreiWald website, and then find the download page, and down this list scroll down to the train animator, and then we see that there are actually two versions available. The version with 2000 images database is a paid version. It sets you back some 30 euros, but the advantage is of course that you have no work to do. If your engine is included in those 2000 images, then you are ready. You can try before you buy and see if the images that you need are indeed included in those 2000, but you cannot use them. They are watermarked and they are licensed, somehow they don't work in the program, obviously. But then if you don't mind to do a little work yourself, then you are free to download the second version, the free program. Click this button, download it and install it, which is all quite straightforward. So let's look how that ends up on our desktop. We find then a TC animator shortcut. Let's click that and see what happens. Okay, program opens up, and the first thing that we need to do now obviously is find an image that of our engine that we like to use. What this program does, by the way, is two things. As we see over here with this default engine that it opens up with, the surroundings of the engine are stripes, with diagonal stripes, and that means they are transparent in the image, which means in Traincontroller, with a white background it will look like this, and with a colored background it will look like this. And this is what we can do with the program to get this transparency outside the engine pixels, and then it will transfer it to this special file format. Well, first task is find the image of the engine that we need. Well, of course we could take an image with our digicam, but most of the time I prefer to use an image that I can simply find on the internet. I have a Dutch engine called the 1800. Let's see if we can find image of that. Go to the images, and well, a lot of real life images, but yeah, I'm trying to find one with a uniform white background. This one, this seems like a nice one, and let's just download it. I'm going to right click it and save this image and say over here that this is now my Dutch Railway 1800. Save. Okay, it should be on my hard disk now. And then the question is, should I open it here in the train controller or maybe first do something with it? I'm referring to the issue of file size. I've read in some forums that quite a few people ended up with a quite large file size after using this animator program. And yeah, the best thing to do is, because the icons are actually quite small in the train controller program, not to start with a very large image. The magic number seems to be here 48 pixels of height. If you could create an image of 48 pixels, that is a very good starting point for this animator program. However, the editor that is included in the program is not a full-fledged editor, and some functions, amongst which file size or image size, are missing. So we first need an external editor to do this little shrinking. Well, if you don't have an image editor on your personal computer, that's no issue. Nowadays, there are quite a few very nice image editors available on the internet. One of them, for instance, is this one, pixlr.com. It opens up this website, and if we click this little arrow, we get this choice to launch a web app, and I'm clicking that now, and it asks to open an image from the computer. Well, I just saved this image and we have it now over here, and we can edit this image and do almost anything that Photoshop can do. Alternatively, we could also download an image, an editor, sorry. There is a very nice editor available free of charge. It's freeware. It is called the FastStone Image Viewer. Well, that name is a little bit confusing. It sounds like a viewer, but actually it includes a full-fledged and very nice user interface editor. Free for download and install, and then you have it on your computer. And I personally find that a bit more convenient than always going to the internet. Right, so I have this program installed, and let me just go to my file manager and open this image that I just downloaded. Here it is. It's now open in this FastStone viewer. It shows over here at the bottom, I hope that is visible, that it is 300 pixels. Well, let me first crop the image a little bit. I now went to the left side of the image and it automatically opens a menu, and there is a crop board, and over there I'm going to take out vertically every pixel that I don't need. So I take out most of the air above the engine and also the rails at the bottom. That is now I have for my 48 pixels to which I'm going to shrink this image, I have maximum use of the surface with engine pixels, so to speak. So let me hit enter. That crops the image, and now I'm again going to the left side to resize the image, and I need 48 pixels, and I need to take care that I preserve the aspect ratio, of course. Hit OK, and now the image is a lot smaller. Okay, down here is the save, and let me save this as an NS1800, but now 48 pixels to distinguish them. Okay, this work is done now in an external editor. I hit escape to get out, and I have now in my file manager the original image and a 48 pixel high image, a small image, and we see also the file size is a very nice small number. Right, let's now go to the animator editor and see if we can find that image. I am in my temporary directory, but okay, I apparently have to refresh that, so let's click somewhere else and then click temp again. Yeah, now over here are my images. Let me double click the 48 one, And it opens up over here, as we see, nicely. However, we can see here that the image shows good on a white background, but not yet good on a dark background. That's because the transparency is not already there. Yeah, the animator does an attempt to do that automatically, but more often than not, it requires still some fine-tuning. You might also wonder what are these sliders over here. Well, you can take away a little bit of the picture at the bottom side. In this case, that is not very useful, as we see in the preview, so I just keep it at the bottom, because I already took care of cropping my image very nice, so I don't need that slider. Then we have another slider that does something at the top of the image, but also for me that is totally useless. So I can keep both sliders where they were. This one was at 10, I believe. I don't know why this needs to be 10, but that seems to be the value that works. Okay, this is so those sliders, if you start with 48 pixels, you don't even need to worry about those sliders. Just leave them where they are. Now, the final task is to get this transparency, if we like that. Of course, you can use the image as it is right now, but I like the transparency. So let's go to edit mode, and let's see how we can get that done. First, I'm going to click here to enlarge it 10 times. Then I'm now zoomed in a bit. Then what I always do, that's a personal preference maybe, I take away the grid, so that I can better see where the pixels of the engine are. Then I make the color transparent, the top color. And then I go to this fill rectangle. And then I simply fill all the areas that need to become transparent with the transparent color. And well, it is just a little bit of work, but not too much. And it takes a few seconds. I will just do the left side right now. For the sake of time, we will skip the rest of the image and not do all the other parts. That will take too long. But I am now nicely on the way to get this whole area transparent. And yeah, that is good enough. And well, this may be sometimes you have to make a choice what you do with the pixels. Let's take out the rails also and just look at the wheels. So this is the picture, the left side I did now. Let's have a look at the preview. Every now and then you can have a look at the preview. Yeah, that's a bit strange. Sometimes when I click OK, the preview does not immediately show. I don't know why. Then I have to click edit again, and then OK again, and then it shows over here. Well, I think we did a pretty nice job to get that left side transparent. For the sake of time, I'm not going to do the complete image, but as you saw, it's only a matter of a minute or a few minutes, and then you have that done. Okay, and now we can save this image. Let's do file save as. And yeah, I had already done that as a preparation for this video, so I copy it again. But now I have this special file format on my disk. Then we can get out of this program and now into Traincontroller. Well, let me add a new engine. Go here to the train and then create engine. Yeah, I have a new one over here. And I want my new image to be glued to this engine. So click over here. And oh no, so sorry, not click over here, browse of course now. And now I can open this image, and yes, that opens up my new image. Well, we can clearly see that it is the new image, because only the left side is transparent and the right side is still white. Okay, that's a pity. Let me put that image over here and let's see how that looks. I should have put it over there. Then the left side again is transparent and the right side is still white. But that's because of the sake of time, I did not finish the editing. Well, actually, this is what I liked to show in this video. It is possible to use your own images. You start with a large image, probably, that you make or that you find on the internet. Then you shrink it to the magic number 48 pixels high. Then go into the animator to make the surroundings transparent, and then you're actually done. Not much work, but yeah, if you don't like any work at all, then you can purchase the 2000 images database. Well, the next video we are still going to talk about images, and that will be about engines, I mean, and it will be about grouping engines, clustering them in sets of similar specifications for later selection, ease of selection with different functions. So let's have a look how we can group engines in the next video. Maybe see you back there. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.